My day is planned. I know what I have to fit in between. I know when my breaks are. And that is motivating for me, knowing that I'm going to get this big wedge of work done. So how is it that you're motivating yourself with your work? You know, how is it that you're keeping that inspiration going, even against the odds? Because often it is against the odds, isn't it? You've got so many other things to do, being bombarded by information. You've got so much research to do on a client, whatever it is, that you're not maintaining that motivation. Hello and welcome. Mentoring with Geraldine is a bite-sized practitioner podcast for naturopaths, nutritionists, herbalists, and practitioners. This podcast responds directly to your needs, the needs of the practicing natural therapist. With interviews, herbal discussions, something business, and something clinical each week, you'll get the variety you need and enjoy to stay motivated in practice. Hello, and welcome to Mentoring with Geraldine and the Bite Size Podcast. How are you today? How are things going in your small business? So, small business success, what do we think of small business success? How do we think of small business success? What is it that you consider to be small business success? So, where our underlying values and thoughts lie is where we're thinking is our success. So our success metrics, what are they? Are they what we see on social media? Are they comparisonitis? What are our metrics for ourselves? Are they paying the bills? Is it paying the mortgage? What is it that then creates your success? What is it that tells you you're a success? And I think we need to think about this a little bit more than we do. Is it that you're always busy? But are you making any money with that always busy? How is it that you prioritize your time to create what you need to feel you're a success in business? Is it monetary success? Is it psychological success? Where does that success metric work for you? Because, you know, if you know the type of business, when you go out there and you go, this is my type of business, you know, I'm a one-to-one consultant, and on the side, I have a shop that sells my products. Or what is it that is your niche business? And where are you headed with that? Have you got that long-term plan? So we really need to nut out a plan. We really need to know where we're going. So, and we do this in the academy. So I'm always a little bit vague about what the academy is and what it has in it. And it's because it's around your business and it's focusing on seeing the client, talking to the client, encouraging that business mindset, encouraging all the skills around boundaries and organizing your time. And the goal setting, it's about community. So there's a lot of things in the academy that often I don't explain to people, and I don't get out there properly in the world as to what the academy is. And I do realize that this is an error of mine. It's something that I love. I've got 89 people in there. And because as soon as you do one of my other courses, you're automatically a member of the academy whilst you're on that course. So it means we've got, you know, like 80 people. Some people will dip in, some people won't. Some people turn up to the lives. We have three lives, but they're on Zoom and recorded into Facebook. So you're actually there. You're in the hot seat and you're asking your questions, or you're just listening, you're chatting, whatever it is that you need to go through. But it means I'm encouraging people and I'm supporting people with their plan because I get to know them. So I know that somebody's redecorating their office. They finally got the, you know, the front office redecorated, and it's, Kay, are you listening? You know, and their office is waiting now. I know these things about people because I spend time with those people in the group. And it also means I'm looking at them for their roadmap of their business. You know, what tools and strategies do you need in your business? Where are you going with your business? What is your long-term trajectory with that? So, you know, I actually did a one-to-one call with, she's a student last week. She just booked in for half an hour with me to help with some decision-making towards, you know, she's due to qualify in a few months. And so she wanted help with some, you know, decision-making, with some systems, what she should be looking at, questions she should be asking, ideas about when she goes out into the world. And so She's, you know, she's finding out what tools do I need? What strategies do I need? What is my roadmap to success? You know, am I going to work for somebody else first? How, what does that look like? How do I understand that through to working for myself? Should I be a contractor for those people? Should I be going into places and saying, you know, I want to contract and just rent the room? How does this work with different businesses and what tools do I need? So we had a very action-packed 30 minutes, really sorting out, nutting out some tools and strategies for her as she moves her business forward. And along with all of this, you know, along with these strategies and tools, you know, the mindset, we've got to have our mindset set for resilience and motivation, because there are a lot of knockbacks. Actually, I'm going to talk about that next time. I'm going to talk about our knockbacks. I will get to that. Let's talk about motivation and staying motivated in our own business. And part of that is turning up. If you're renting a room, it means going into that room. So for me, I have my office at home. So my boundaries and my motivation can get a little bit sidetracked because I'll put the laundry in, or I'll go and do something else, another job here or there, because I'm at home. So maintaining that motivation where you're working can be difficult. Setting those boundaries for yourself. I've talked about the 2-minute rule before, making sure that I get those jobs done. So before I come into the office, I've cleaned up the kitchen, I've done the dishes, I've wiped the table, I've put in a load of laundry, but I know that that's an hour and a half in the washing machine. So I'll sit down and I'll work hard for an hour and a half, and then I'll go out and deal with it. So I use some of those jobs as motivators, as time limiters. Okay, so what is your mindset to keep you going? And often what I'll find is I'll do these job-like things in the morning and I'll use them as motivators. Okay, I've got an hour and a half now because washing's on. I'm going to do this part of this webinar or something. And then I will go out, deal with the drying, laundry, whatever it is, come back to my office 20 minutes later, having had my stand up and being congratulated by my watch that I've stood up. And I'll come back to my office and then I will just sit down and work solidly, and I won't realize until the door goes, my husband's walking in or my daughter's come in from school or whatever it is, that, oh, I've actually been solidly working all afternoon. I hadn't noticed. So I've managed to motivate myself knowing that I've got little jobs done and then I'm going to sit down and crank out a heap of work. Today, for example, I've already been online. I have a small next level group and we talk about clients. So that one isn't really advertised, because we talk about clients, it's clinical, and they can only be small groups because everyone gets 15, 20 minutes to talk about their clients. And I've got that at 11:30. That'll be about an hour and a half. Then I'm going to do some podcasting. Then I've got a meeting for a conference that I'm in. And then I've got the Graduate Mastery Program students this afternoon at 6 p.m. tonight. And we're going to go through, we're doing acne today. We're doing eczema and acne. So, you know, it's my day is planned. I know what I have to fit in between. I know when my breaks are. And that is motivating for me, knowing that I'm going to get this big wedge of work done. So how is it that you're motivating yourself with your work? You know, how is it that you're keeping that inspiration going, even against the odds? Because often it is against the odds, isn't it? You've got so many other things to do, being bombarded by information. You've got so much research to do on a client, whatever it is, that you're not maintaining that motivation. And that's where the academy comes in, and that you are there, you're getting that motivation from the group. I'm always turning up. I'm live in there at those times that I say I'm going to be there, you know, and it means that you can begin to roadmap that business the way you want it to be. And I'm still roadmapping mine all the time. And, you know, I'm juggling clients and mentees. And so when you're trying to juggle things, I've now had to roadmap when I'm going to see my clients, v when I'm going to see my mentees, v when I'm going to have a break, because I have a tendency to just work. And so I need to schedule in those breaks. And chances are you do too, because you're listening to this and you're working still, kind of. You're going, I'll listen to Geraldine. So it's not really work, but it is, because some of these you get CPE for. So, you know, we really need to think, where am I going with my business for my small business success? You know, and in the academy, I do support people in their business with their business challenges. We talk business, but we talk motivation. We talk coaching the client. It's supporting you in that one-to-one environment. So I don't call it business mentoring as such. It's more practice mentoring, because it's about your practice and it's about making sure your practice works, your practice functions, your practice flows. Okay. So that's kind of more what the academy is. It's kind of business, but more practice. But it's practice and it's business. I don't know. You'll have to decide for yourself. 7 days free. Come and decide for yourself. There's tons and tons of stuff. So Podia is where I store all my resources these days. So that is chocker with academy information. And then in the Facebook group is where we put the live recording. So there's, and I've got a Telegram channel that I put little motivations on every so often. So, you know, if you're interested, 7 days free. Check it out. You know, you can, links are everywhere. And I hope you're seeing me on social media. And I'd love to hear from you. You know, if you want to email me or you want to book a focus call with me, you know, get in touch. The links are in the show notes from today. But I'm around. You can check me out, geraldinehedley.com. And if you wanted to email me, I'm geraldine@mentoringwithgeraldine.biz, because I'd love to hear from you. And of course, if you've stayed all this way through, maybe a 5-star review, go for it. Love it. Okay, I'm going to let you go now. Have an absolutely brilliant rest of day, won't you? Bye. Thanks so much for joining me today. Don't forget to rate, review, and subscribe to the podcast for the weekly episodes. If you'd like even more support and learning, then the Academy is for you. Here you'll find part 2 of the herbal discussions, more clinical learning, and case studies to support your clients in practice. Bye for now.